Perhaps no aircraft carrier has been as mocked or as troubled as Admiral Kuznetsov, Russia's only carrier and the sole ship of its class. The Admiral Kuznetsov aircraft carrier of Project 11435 will complete the overhaul and upgrade in 2023 and will rejoin the Navy in the end of the year, Vice President of the United Shipbuilding Corporation, Vladimir Korolev told TASS at the Navy Salon. The avionics, flight deck with the ski jump, electric equipment, and the power plant will be replaced. The carrier will receive a new fully domestic takeoff and landing control system. The air power will remain the same. The carrier will have no attack weapons, it will be armed with Pantsir-M anti-aircraft complex. Following the sinking of one of the world's largest dry docks on October 29, 2018 in a shipyard in the far northwest part of Russia, officials have finally admitted that they were unable to continue work on Russia's sole aircraft carrier, the Admiral Kuznetsov. The Admiral Kuznetsov was commissioned in 1990 and last underwent a two-year refit between 1996 and 1998. The Russian Navy's 55,000-ton flagship has never been deployed for longer than 6 months and famously had to be followed by an ocean-going tugboat during all of its sea voyages due to the carrier's poor reliability and questionable performance during a recent deployment to Syria in 2016. The refit has increased the carrier's aircraft capacity from 24 to 26 fighter jets and as many as 12 helicopters. The modifications also aim to upgrade the electronics and propulsion system and likely will remove the P-700 missiles. Russia has also put effort into replacing or modernizing the aging Su-33, as it is really only capable of aerial warfare with limited ground attack options. The MiG-29K, a naval version of the MiG-29, is expected to have a larger role in Russia's future carrier air wings. The carrier could also carry the Kar-52K Katrin attack helicopter. When fully operational, the carrier, like the Russian Navy's other legacy platforms, will likely be used to show the flag and demonstrate Russia's naval status, even as the fleet continues to shift its focus to small, missile-laden vessels and submarines. Five years after commissioning its first aircraft carrier, the Liaoning, China launched its second carrier, the Shandong, on April 26, 2017. Unlike its Soviet-built predecessor, the Shandong is China's first domestically built carrier. Both carriers are similar in size and use a short takeoff but arrested recovery system for the launch and recovery of aircraft. Although similar to the Liaoning, the Shandong features some notable enhancements and represents an important step in China's developing aircraft carrier program. Because of their essentially common but not identical designs, Shandong was initially believed to be designated as a Type 001A carrier by many analysts. But the Keiji Chinese government finally confirmed in December 2021 the new vessel will instead go by the Type 002 designation. Shandong can carry more fighters than its predecessor but won't necessarily do so for a while. The Liaoning can carry a total of 36 aircraft, including 24 jet fighters. For the Shandong, Chinese naval architect made the island the built-up superstructure on a carrier, deck taller but occupying smaller in surface area. That affords the Shandong deck space for 44 aircraft in total, including up to 32 fighter jets. That's useful but doesn't mean the Pla Navy will be max out each carrier's air wing, as there are rumored to be only around 50 J-15s fighters in service so far, and some of those will also be needed for land-based training and rotations. Indeed, according to the South China Morning Post article, only 30 pilots and 24 J-15s appeared to be deployed on the carrier. One thing that bears monitoring will be whether Shandong's air wing incorporates any J-15D electronic warfare jets equipped with jamming pods to serve alongside the regular model. A J-15D was already spotted on Shandong's deck in 2018. A ESA electronically scanned array radar with four antennae facing in different directions are basically today's gold standard in radars, as they boast higher resolution, are more discreet than other powerful radars, and are much more resistant to jamming. Quality radars are vital to provide carriers with air traffic control, coordinate combat operations, and detect incoming threats. Its J-15 Flying Shark fighters theoretically outperform US Navy Super Hornets on some metrics. But in reality, they can't carry nearly as much fuel and weapons. The J-15 is copied from a prototype Sukhoi Su-33 flanker China bought from Ukraine, just like the carrier. Shandong may well end up being the only Type 002 carrier to enter Pla Navy service. That's because the third and fourth carriers currently under construction will be larger, more capable design with a large flat deck and electromagnetic catapults that will allow onboard jets to take off with full weapons and fuel loads.
The Gerald R. Ford class is the future aircraft carrier replacement class for Enterprise and Nimitz-class aircraft carriers. The lead ship, Gerald R. Ford, was commissioned in 2017. The Gerald R. Ford class will be the premier forward asset for crisis response and early decisive striking power in a major combat operation. Gerald R. Ford-class aircraft carriers and carrier strike groups will provide the core capabilities of forward presence, deterrence, sea control, power projection, maritime security and humanitarian assistance. The second carrier of this class, USS John F. Kennedy, was christened and launched in December 2019. The vessel is scheduled to be commissioned in 2020. While further ships of the class will enter service at five-year intervals. A total of 10 Ford-class carriers are planned with construction continuing to 2058. The latest full-ship shock trials or FSST test took place in the Atlantic Ocean on July 16, 2021, on the fourth anniversary of the ship's commissioning. These tests are conducted on new ship designs to validate the hardness of the ship, designed to demonstrate the ship's ability to withstand the effects of nearby underwater explosion and retain required capability. The trials use some 40,000 pounds of explosives, detonated in close proximity, to confirm that warships can continue to meet mission requirements under harsh conditions they might encounter in battle. Improvements aboard Ford will be carried forward to the next two carriers of the Ford class, John F. Kennedy and Enterprise. Each ship in the new class will save nearly $4 billion in total ownership costs during its 50-year service life, compared to the Nimitz class. The CVN-78 is designed to operate effectively with almost 700 fewer crew members than a John F. Kennedy class ship. Improvements in the ship design will also allow the embarked air wing to operate with fewer personnel. The new A-1B reactor, electromagnetic aircraft launch system, advanced arresting gear, and dual-band radar all offer enhanced capability with reduced manning. The Gerald R. Ford class is designed to maximize the striking power of the embarked carrier air wing. The ship's systems and configuration are optimized to maximize the sortie generation rate of attached strike aircraft, resulting in a 33% increase in SGR over the Nimitz class. The ship's configuration and electrical generating plant are designed to accommodate new systems, including direct energy weapons, during its 50-year service life. The Gerald R. Ford class builds upon the Navy's legacy of aircraft carrier innovation, stretching back to the first aircraft carrier, USS Langley, and continuing to the present day. Ford continues the aircraft carrier history of innovation and adaptability that will enable her to serve our country for decades to come.